The conversation continues on Houston's Morning News with Matt Patrick.
KTRH News Time is 7:47. Joining me right now, the editor of Kickoff Sports, Jim Gumb. Jim, welcome to Houston's Morning News.
Well, thank you for having me. I appreciate it.
I got to play the Baylor fight song. A lot of Baylor fans calling up this morning, very upset that I'm not focusing enough on Baylor going to the Alamo Bowl. So we thought we'd play the fight song and make them feel a little bit better today.
Well, I tell you what, listen, we all know what these bowls are about. The bowls all are about making a profit. And that's why you see so many local teams going to bowls. You know, they want fans in. They want fannies in the seats.
Right.
And the closer a team or campus is, more likely they're going to select them over someone else if it's a close call.
And, you know, and I'm glad you brought that up because you're right. You know, with the loss by the Cougs, speaking of bowl games, they have lost more than just a perfect season, Jim, which is sad, and it was just heartbreaking to watch that football game over the weekend. But they've also lost millions of dollars. I mean, you go to the Sugar Bowl, you're going to make, what, 4 or 5 times as much money as you're going to make at the Ticket City Bowl.
Oh, there's no question. I mean, that loss was an economic disaster. Obviously, Southern Miss is not going to lay down for them. But let's just be honest, Houston just got outplayed. Southern Miss came to play, and they performed, admirably. And, this is a Southern Miss team that had just two very, very bad losses, especially the UAB loss. I mean, how did Southern Miss lose to UAB and then beat Houston in Houston? That just goes to show you just never know.
And I, I've heard from people, I don't buy into this, but I've heard from people that that the Cougs just didn't take it didn't take Southern Miss seriously, that they were just kind of riding high, looked past them. I don't know if that's true. I didn't necessarily get that impression, but by the way they played, that may have very well been the case. I mean, the defense looked horrible.
Yeah, I don't think they overlooked Southern Mississippi because Southern Miss has dominated Conference USA since that league was formed, and obviously, they came in with a really good record. They just had two bad losses, and we all know. Listen, we see upsets happen all the time. The better team doesn't necessarily win every game.
Jim Gump.
When you see Iowa State beat Oklahoma State,
yeah.
Listen, there's no way that Iowa State's a better team, but they just happen to win that particular game.
Jim Gumb is the editor of Kickoff Sports. He's joining us here this morning. All right, if you can hang on real quick, coming back, I want to talk about the Aggies, what's going on there, who you see maybe going in. I don't know if any of us have a crystal ball that is really very accurate, but let's at least get your thoughts. Jim Gumb, editor of Kickoff Sports, joining us here this morning. KTRH News Time is 7:52. Jim Gumb, editor of Kickoff Sports, joining us. All right, let's talk a little bit about the Aggies. If someone goes there, does that kick the entire U of H student body and team right in the groin, do you think?
Oh, there's no doubt. But, I look at this, and, the window of opportunity sometimes can be very, very small for a coach in his situation. I look at Greg Schiano at Rutgers. A few years ago, he was a real hot commodity, and supposedly he turned down a Michigan job. Now, you don't hear his name mentioned as often for the big job. So, if you're a hot name right now, you have to take these jobs when they're aren't there because you're not guaranteed that you're going to be a hot name next year or 2 years from now.
How long before the Aggies get better, Jim, in your estimation? I mean, I would assume that it is going to take a little while.
It's going to take a little while, but you've got to get a coach who can recruit. Obviously, going in the Southeastern Conference, that's going to open up doors into some of the states like Florida, Georgia, and the Carolinas. I think that you can better recruit those areas if you're going to be playing teams from those states. So, but you got to get somebody that honestly can coach them up. It's one thing to be a great recruiter. I mean, I look at Ron Zook, great recruiter, super recruiter, but he just didn't seem to be able to coach his players up once he got them. You got to be able to do both. You've got to get the players, but you got to do something with them once you've got them. And there's very few coaches out there, to me, that can do that.
Jim,
and someone obviously is a hot name, so he's the guy I'm looking at right now.
All right, very good. Jim Gumb, I thank you, my friend, for your time here this morning. He's the editor of Kickoff Sports. Make sure that you check that out. Jim, thank you, sir.